Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is Days Gone part 19, I believe. Yeah, last time we went and took revenge on the Reapers and Carlos or Jesse, and it was fun, you know, breaking the dam and going into their territory and looking for Carlos and stuff. But we see what we have to do now. I guess it's time to start like closing up the caves and taking care of hordes, but we'll see what happens. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, share it with your friends, and we'll see what we have to do on this one. Alright, let's see what this mission is about.
No, this is your clutch.
I know where the clutch is.
Do you want me to show you how to do this or not?
Yes, but I know where the clutch is.
Okay. Alright, you do it yourself, okay?
Hey! What are you doing? You can't park here.
I'm just here to pick
up
Sarah.
It's private property. Now turn around, get the hell out of here. Come on.
Okay.
Move it.
Yep. Okay. You know what though? I think I'm just gonna wait right here. You can go back to doing your guard the cornfields thing.
This is Officer Moore at the gate. We got an issue here. Hey, listen, asshole. This is a restricted area. I told you, get the hell out of here. Okay. Hey, you just wait right there. I told you. Move it.
It's like I was trying to say, I'm just here
you
to pick up...
Did you not see that sign?
Oh, look at that. That's kind of hard to miss.
I'm authorized to use deadly force.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Hey, whoa, what's going on?
I'm sorry, Miss Whitaker.
It's fine,
Jim. Do you know this asshole?
Yeah, he's with me. He's with me.
Sorry, ma'am. I didn't know that...
It's fine. Honestly, I apologize.
Shh. Oh, and Jim!
Deacon!
I'm not with her. She's with me.
Hold on tight. You can always do that.
Do what?
Act like such a dick.
Oh, come on. He started it.
It's in his name.
Hey, watch the clutch. Remember, you gotta give it enough gas, rev up the RPMs.
I got this.
Yeah, I can hear. Where are we headed?
Over to the dam. That's a nice quiet road, right?
Are you driving? No.
Are we still going out tonight? You said something might come up.
Crap, yeah. Boozer and the boys want to ride down to Clam Estate, visit Jack.
So you're gonna blow me off to go see some guy in prison?
Jack's not some guy.
I know. I was kidding.
Okay. Is this the same road we took with Ricky? Going to the dam?
Oh shit, look out!
What?
Oh god. Oh my god.
Really?
Jesus! I don't know what it is, but every time I'm on a bike with you, some idiot in a truck tries to run us off the road.
Oh my god, no, listen, you did great. Most people, they would have panicked, they would have oversteered, and that would have gotten us killed.
I almost did get us killed. I wasn't paying attention, and I was distracted.
Hey, it's okay. Just breathe, you're okay. Wait a second, what did you mean distracted?
No, it's just stuff going on at work, it's nothing, I just...
Oh. Okay. No, I just thought maybe you saw my new patch.
Your what?
No patch.
Nomad? Wait, you quit the club?
No, I didn't quit the club. I would never quit the club. Nomad, what it means is, I'll be less involved from now on.
Dick, I didn't ask you to do that.
Oh, I know. And if you had, I would have said no. You ready to try this again?
Yeah. I mean, no, but yeah, I will.
Okay. Thank you for saving my life.
Well, you know, I do what I can.
Hey, the clutch.
I know what the clutch is.
Okay, no, the...
Deacon.
So, do you think your parents are gonna come?
To the wedding? I don't know.
I mean, you know, I thought if I stepped back from the MC that,
I don't think it's gonna matter to them, Deacon.
But you're gonna at least tell them.
Yeah, if you want me to. Look, it's just change who I am and who you are to make my uptight middle-class parents happy.
Okay.
Okay. You say so.
Look out!
I see them.
Hey, are they headed to your work?
They know they're going to their work.
Are any of them coming now that you've gone Nomad?
Oh, I don't know. It's probably been a while since any of them set foot in a chapel. And you really want 27 Harleys rolling up in that little church in Marion Forks?
Yeah. You know what? As a matter of fact,
really?
I do.
Okay.
Is she being sarcastic? Let's see what's going on.
What's going on?
I don't know.
Miss Whitaker.
Yeah.
Chief's been trying to get a hold of you, says it's urgent.
It's always urgent. Let him know I'll be right there.
Okay.
I gotta go.
Hey.
Sorry. It's fine. It's probably just a fire alarm or something small.
Okay. How come dead?
Love you. Just call me later.
Addie, I'm sorry.
Whatever.
Okay.
Addie, whatever, Ricky.
I'm sorry.
Really? Damn. They fight over everything.
Clearance. O'Brien, this is St. John. Come back. O'Brien, this is St.
Just answer your goddamn radio!
St. John, didn't think I'd hear from you again.
Yeah, neither did I. All right, listen, that night you bugged out. You told me that you didn't take any civilians. You just took Nero personnel, feds, people with clearance.
I told you there was nothing we could
do. Shut up. Listen to me. Sarah, my wife, she had clearance. She had her ID badge with her the night that I put her on your chopper. Do me a favor, look it up. Sarah Irene Whitaker. She worked at Cloverdale. She had federal clearance. She was doing, research, pharmaceutical. I don't know what the hell she was doing.
I'll see what I can find.
Really?
Okay, great. O'Brien, remember, you owe me.
Yeah. O'Brien out.
Didn't you get over it? See, Brent, her picture with the chapel and everything.
Had a small office and a dog.
Well, that was it. Okay. Guess I'm gonna have to wait for the next one.
Alright,
we're getting close. We're here.
So what the hell?
I managed to recruit a few guys who I trust who, like me, aren't happy with what's going on.
So why am I here?
I wanted to give you this. You were right about your wife.
Where did you get this?
When Silver Lake evacuated, they took Nero personnel, federal officials, and, well, Sarah Irene Whitaker had a Class 4 federal clearance level.
Clearance level.
The wife bugged out with a recon unit east of Fort Rock.
Take me there.
No.
No? Well, you got a ride. We're all friends now.
The base is gone.
What?
Everything is gone.
A year ago. Local militia group.
Militia group? Where's their camp?
We don't know.
How the hell can you not know? You got a helicopter. You got satellites.
Somewhere around Crater Lake, but it's a no-fly zone, okay? They got outposts, rockets, RPGs.
Crater Lake.
Oh, I want to tell you about the work we're doing. Studying the infected, the freaks. They're evolving.
They're evolving?
As bad as things are right now, they're gonna get worse. A lot worse.
Well, at least we got something, you know, finally. Your ID badge. So where they are research. Alright, so we gotta stay on this trail.
shit about any of that. Boozer! Booze man, come back.
Come on, Boozer.
Hey, listen to me.
Alright, well, let's see. We're here at camp. Let's see if we can find a way to get to that other camp by the lake. See if we can find another clue about Sarah, because we finally really got something. You know, we got her badge and where she was supposed to be and what happened to that place. So we'll see what happens. Let's see. Alright, let's see if Iron Mike will talk.
You know a way over the Teelson Pass. He told me once that
I told you nothing. Go on. I can't help you, Deke.
Just draw me a goddamn map.
After everything you've done.
After everything I've... What about what you've done, old man? Huh? Sherman's camp, the things that you
did.
Get
out of here. You leave me.
Listen to me. What if you could take it all back, huh? What if you could fix it? I thought I put Sarah on a chopper. I felt relieved. How fucked up is that? I was relieved. Mike, that's what I've been living with.
And now you're chasing ghosts. You think finding your old lady, if she's alive, you think that's gonna fix it? Make you whole?
I don't know, but I gotta try.
All right.
Come on, Mike.
If I do this, what you want, show you the way over the pass, you don't come back. All right, you promised me you don't come back.
I got you.
For real? I didn't know Matt again. Really, sir?
I gotta talk to Boozer.
Mate, you won't be able to return to Lost Lake for a while. Really? So if I go, I can't come back. Alright, I guess I'm gonna have to go... buy guns and stuff, like stock up on ammo and stuff, and then I go and talk with Boozer.
Holy shit.
Boozer, I...
Last winter, we were up on Farewell Ridge. We were watching the freaks. Thousands of them. I mean, too many to count.
Yeah, I remember.
All I could think was, every one of us, man, woman, and child, are now homeless. Bunch of goddamn refugees.
Yep.
Yeah. World belongs to them now.
We'll survive.
Yeah, we've been doing that all right. Surviving isn't living. Something Jack used to say. Doesn't matter when you hit the road, where you're heading out to, but you damn well better know where you're coming home to.
You know, we never talked about it. While we still wore the colors. All this time out in the freak show and shit like this didn't matter anymore.
Yeah, but I think. Last two Mongols on Earth, Farewell Originals.
The biker boys, most badass drifters on the broken road.
Damn straight.
Yeah, I guess we did become sort of a brand.
Yeah. We were a lot of things, but we were never a brand.
When we rode out of Farewell, without Sarah, without Jack, or anyone, I knew that we were leaving everything behind. Everything that mattered was gone.
Yep.
Except this.
You're a nomad again, huh?
Yep, I guess I am.
Going after that chance. That if Sarah is alive.
Come on, Jack. Inside, let's go. She's out there. We'll find her.
Deke, you ready?
Yeah, Mike, I'm ready.
Yeah, sure, Mike. Whatever you say.
You don't gotta be a dick, Mike.
Hey.
You heard Big Mike is taking you over the pass?
Yep.
You really think she's still alive? Billions of people are dead, but somehow she made it.
Hey, we made it, didn't we? If I give up now, if I don't do this, well, then I'm just gonna end up
like us, right? Like Iron Mike, like Boozer? What'd you call us, campers, yeah?
You go, and you find your woman. You know where to find me.
And you know what? You know what I think, Deacon? I think that you're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
You ready?
Yeah, I want to get the hell out of here.
Come on, mate.
Okay, I'm following you.
All right, let's see what's waiting for us in the south, I guess. This is what kind of adventure we're gonna get into, because we can't come back for now.
Took Jack out fishing once before, you know.
Oh shit.
I got one. Didn't know what the hell to do with it.
That sounds like Jack.
You ran a pretty tight club. Or you boys raised some hell back in the day. I don't think you murdered anyone. Not in cold blood.
It's not murder if they shoot at you first.
Who's Jack? Is he like a biker friend? I'm guessing.
You know how many tourists we used to get through here come summer?
A few.
Thousands. Too many to count. Highway be bumper to bumper with SUVs and campers chock full of sunburned moms, beer-chugging dads, and their snot-nosed kids. Goddamn rainbow, floppy hats, Hawaiian shirts, and flippy flows. All summer long they come. A trail of colorful ants from L.A. to Farewell to here.
I remember this place. I got a...
I'm glad I avoided road trips out here that time of year.
Small horde from that gas station right there. Oh, and this is where we fought some reapers when we were going to the camp. Well, to the dam, I think. We got stuck here fighting some of them. Come on, Mike. Hit the gas. Really? Let's go, man.
Use the help.
I don't have a choice, Mike.
Fair enough. Come on, just follow me.
Yeah, okay.
That's a hell of a drift. Come on, Mikey. Oh my god. I just crashed into everything. Here I go again. What the hell is wrong with this bike? Oh, it's just snow out here.
The trail. It'll take you down the mountain, on into the diamond-like valley. I wish you luck. Hope you're right about your old lady still being alive.
She is.
Well, maybe so. But you gotta ask yourself, Deke.
We'll see if she's alive.
What does it matter if everyone else is dead?
Alright, let's go. Right to the summit. Let's go. Alright, we're here.
If you're out there.
I thought he burnt the picture. In the chapel. What, gunfire already?
Mayday! Mayday! Captain Corey, you there? Come in! Mayday! No one's listening. Damn it! Try again!
What the hell?
Oh, damn. Bear. Do I have any? And I can't do any. Cool. Ah, damn. Damn, again. Run. What are you doing? What? Oh my god. Okay, okay. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay. Got it. Alright, took care of that bear.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't know what we would have done without you, man.
Oh, come on.
Hey, okay, alright. It's dead, it's cool.
Man of the hour.
Oh, God. I'm Russell, Glenn Russell. This is Private Mullins.
Rick.
Hey, Rick. I'm Deacon St. John. Did you say private?
Yeah. It's the Deschutes County Militia.
You're not from around here. You come over the pass?
No. I've just been drifting. I came over the salt flats east of Silver Lake.
What? What the hell are you doing out here, man? How'd you get across the 97?
Whoa. Jesus, man.
What?
This guy just saved your freaking life.
The colonel told us to look out for anybody entering the territory, north or south. Well,
freaking slow your roll, man. We'll let the captain deal with that, okay? He just killed a freaking ranger, dude! Come with us. We got a camp just by Diamond Lake. Get you three hots and a cot. Least we can do.
Okay, yeah, sounds good. What about Flores? We can't just leave him here.
You stay here. I'll come back with some fuel.
No!
Listen, stay here. Use his ammo if you got it. You'll be fine. Okay?
Man, this is gonna be the new schizo.
Following you.
You gotta stick with me, okay? Been having some trouble with squatters out here the past few weeks.
Squatters?
It's Corporal Russell. Open up.
Yeah, let's see what's going on.
Report.
Captain, sir, we had him. We did. Found his bike, still smoking.
I bet you lost him, huh?
No, sir. I mean, yeah, we lost him. We ran into a rager, sir.
Where's Mullins? Flores?
Flores is dead, sir. I'll have Mullins with a body.
That'll be all, Corporal. Go get some fuel. Head back to Mullins. You know what to do.
Yeah. Yes, sir. If it wasn't for this man, we'd all be dead, sir. I sort of promised him some food and a safe place to camp tonight, sir.
Corporal, get the fuck out of here. And you are?
Name's Deacon St. John.
Name's Corey. Derek Corey. Are you okay?
I'm sorry.
That's his ring.
I'm tired. I've been on the road for a long time. Your man Russell said you were recruiting.
Well, are you interested?
I've been looking to settle down. Yeah, find a camp. I'm interested.
Come on.
I bet he's interested in this camp.
So,
seeing that he has
hard to say,
our ring,
lose track of time.
His ring.
So, where'd you get your gear? Ammo?
Well, there's a couple of camps I used to do runs for. Bounty hunting, mostly.
Freaks? Or men?
Both. I had a reputation for being able to track shit down, you know?
Well, which camps? Where are they?
You know, past the Farewell Valley. It doesn't matter. They're gone now. They're overrun. Russell said you were there when Silver Lake was overrun.
Yeah. That was a shit show, I can tell you.
Any survivors?
A few.
Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle course? Why are you not finished with my op-
Here. Take this. Militia script. Camp credits. Payment for helping my men. Use them at any of the commissaries.
Okay.
You gonna join up? Stick around. We're getting ready to ride out of here soon.
Getting ready to ride out where?
You said you had some tracking skills.
Yeah, some.
This isn't the life of a drifter. We're fighting a war out here. You sure you're up for it?
A war?
Is that the best you got?
I can recruit you. But the colonel is the only one who can swear you in. You stick around. Give us a hand. I'll take you to him myself.
I'll be here.
Good.
Jesus, motherfucker has my ring.
Yep.
He took it from Sarah. He had to take it from Sarah because she wouldn't have given it to him. So that means that she's got to be here.
Or in one of their camps.
He doesn't look like a militia. That's all I got.
Moving, sir.
All right. Stuck with this dude.
Hey. You don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man. Name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy shit. Deacon St. John. Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
You see this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Is this, so what, you joining is up, this dude high?
You playing soldier and shit?
I don't know. Maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man. Yesterday. Okay. Yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up. He wouldn't remember Sarah if she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah, come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. Somewhere. Maybe in these tents. Maybe in here.
I really think she's gonna be in one of these tents.
Check this one. The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right? Ah, damn it. She's not here either.
Let's see.
That's gotta be the one. Sarah? Sarah, you in here? Shit, not here. Cute drawings. Oh, God. I'm glad Sarah and I never had kids. Losing them must have been. God damn it, she's not here. Here, but right, yeah, it couldn't be that easy, now, could it?
Yeah, man.
Yes. St. John, are you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah, yeah, I'm here.
Meet me at the gate.
Nice job.
On my way.
Him at the gate, all right.
Getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready when you are.
So you put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, some.
Open it up!
Let's go.
Are you any good? Can you ride?
Yeah. Yeah, I can ride.
You want to join the militia? You're gonna have to prove it to me. See if you can keep up, St. John.
Okay, buddy.
So what the hell happened back there? I mean, it looks like a forest fire, but the stumps are charred. So that means that the timber was cut before it was burned.
You got a good eye. We call it the dead zone. We use the timber to build our barricades, then burn the slash. From the outpost, we can see a horde coming long before it reaches us.
What? Burn all the buildings too, so the newts and the swarmers have nowhere to sleep.
You know your freaks, huh?
Like I said, I've been out in the ship for a long time. So that's your plan, huh? The militia, I mean, to burn everything to the ground.
We're fighting a war out here, St. John. We'll do whatever it takes to win.
A war? Really?
That's what it is, isn't
it? That's their plan.
War?
Burn everything.
Shit. You've seen the hordes. The only thing that's gonna stop them is an army. Our army.
It's gonna take way more than an army.
The colonel lets you join, we'll fill you in. So, Silver Lake, you asked about survivors. Are you looking for someone?
No, not really. I mean, look, there were some folks that I rode with once, and I thought maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after someone. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. I tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
This is it.
This is where the bear was. Yep.
Hey, Corporal, the captain's here. It's done, sir.
Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab, Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
Well, yes, sir.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
You find something?
How long is,
Vasquez?
What has Vasquez been with you guys?
A couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason, I can't track him from the bike. God.
Okay.
Where do we start? It's been snowing, so there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
Let's go, let's go.
You, you said he stole rations, ammo?
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it. His bike's still out front, which means that he went out the back.
Okay.
Wait, over here.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently?
Yeah, come on, this way.
All right, man. Let's see. Let's see. Oh, it's the map is red.
Hey, hold on for a second. Look over here.
Track?
Oh, tracks.
Yeah, we're in luck. This way.
Wait. Hold up. You find something?
Yeah. Shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here.
It's the wolf.
Hold up. Go on, get out of here.
What are you doing? The wolf?
Depends.
Look out! More wolves!
I see him.
Why are they coming after me? Like, I'm the only one here.
That's the last of them. Yeah.
All right.
Like nice work. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot right through the head.
Yeah, the wolves must have heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
You think they chased off Vasquez, leaving one to guard the carcass?
That's my guess.
Come on, let's see if you're right.
You guys got a lot of wolves out here. Ones that aren't infected, I mean.
Yeah, we get reports almost every day.
When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies.
Well, it looks like they're making a big comeback.
What? Come on, can I run? We're gonna have to walk it the rest of the way.
Hold up.
What is it?
It's a backpack.
It's one of ours.
Looks like they almost got to him.
And he shrugged off the pack to get away.
Nah. To buy time. He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots.
You can tell all that.
Yeah.
Finally, I can run.
Scattered all over the region.
Yeah, well, maybe that explains why Vasquez came through here. Let's go around.
Exactly what I was thinking.
All right, let's follow the captain.
St. John, this way.
Yeah, right there with you. I gotta say, I'm getting tired running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah, I've done it before. You just gotta keep moving.
Look, you're gonna join the militia? You must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight freaks.
Being in the shit, killing freaks, it kinda goes hand in hand, doesn't it? Okay, put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell the corpse for about a mile out.
Part of our slash and burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything else.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them just in this part of the state alone.
Yeah, we gotta start somewhere.
Okay, let's go.
Alright, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
What are we gonna find? What are we gonna find? Let's see.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead, or he's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Hmm. Okay. Come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The colonel will fill you in, if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't want you to get your hopes up.
Hey, don't worry about me. I don't really... Hey, wait. Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Well, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. If Vasquez is there, what would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead. Why?
Well, it means Vasquez isn't coming without a fight.
Okay.
Do you see your man?
Okay.
That's him.
Oh, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Oh, come on, Vasquez. Oh, we'll see about that. Oh, hell no.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order? You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
That's St. John for you. Okay, kill all of them. Okay, I got one. Two. Mark it. Oh.
Men coming! Now I got you.
That one. Got you.
Yes.
See if I can get the dude with the sniper. Okay, got you. Out of bullets. Cool. Oh my god, I have to get closer.
Oh,
I got you.
What do you think? You're walking away from this?
Is that the last of them?
I think so. Nice work.
Come on, let's go deal with
your
man.
Yeah. Vasquez,
he isn't my man. Not anymore.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Wait here. Stand guard in case we missed anyone.
You can handle him?
He won't know what hit him. Door's jammed.
This is how it goes
locked.
Down.
It's locked, so... through the roof?
Hey, you're warning me? That's too goddamn funny.
Where am I gonna go in through? Through that door? No.
Yeah, this is it. I can get in through here.
Oh, she got him.
Hey, whoa. Easy, easy. I'm just here to help.
I don't need your goddamn help.
Okay. I'm just gonna move over here.
She got him.
Hell away from me.
Hold on now. We're not with them.
You think I give a damn who you are?
Okay. What the hell was that?
Just your typical damsel in distress.
Vasquez?
Done. Way done.
Captain Corey, come in.
This is Corey.
We're here, heading up the road to the main gate.
Hold your position there. We're coming.
What about the enemy?
They've been, neutralized. Hold your position. Curry out. Come on.
We brought up your bikes, Captain. Thought we'd save you the walk back.
That'll be all, Corporal.
So how'd I do? Did I pass? Pass? Well, you've been watching me all day. I figured this was what? Some kind of test.
No. Nothing quite as formal as all that. As you can see, our pool of recruits isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah. You passed. Oh. You ready to meet the colonel?
Yeah, sure. Why the hell not?
All right. Let's do this then.
So, St. John. Where did you serve? Before the shit went down. Hey, you know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover in advance, tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? I mean, first year out here, it seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army, 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain bearing. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years, part of SAC.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days.
Really?
So, are you familiar with this area?
Yeah, I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell, you know it?
No. It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, we stopped by here on our honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when...
Anyway, when that happened.
It was a long time ago.
Another memory?
You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Keep
oh,
out.
No, that doesn't apply to us.
Why? Because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chivalrous what?
No, it means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, he didn't even have a cell phone?
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did.
What is with all these memories, man? I'm trying to get to the bottom of this. I want to see if Sarah's alive.
So, where are we going?
Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
Are we going to end up at the same place that we're at with the captain right now?
Stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw biker.
Well, I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear a sweater.
An outlaw biker?
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Oh, come on, Deacon. I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I'm just... I mean, I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
The question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Oh, well, okay, wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there, that's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
This is a long walk.
Oh, I know.
Come on, stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean, you, well, you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... it's just this project, and we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even showing me the spec, and...
Ooh, well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... you know what, like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah. This is a long-ass walk. I at least want to jog.
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that. Pot farm.
Really?
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah. I mean, you got me. I was hoping that you could give us some tips, you know, cultivation. Put all those PhDs to work on something actually useful.
Jesus, Deacon, what?
Really?
This was it? I get it. This is not actually what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on, keep following the trail. We're almost there.
Okay, let's go.
You think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
God, look at that moonlight. It's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean like all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean the moonlight, the wildflowers, and the fireflies. I see you were kidding again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Oh, yeah, right.
I do.
You do not. Like when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay.
Really?
First of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you turn it into a joke.
Okay, all right. We do need to talk about it. And we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See?
Okay, a waterfall?
This is why I brought you out here.
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yeah?
Will you?
Will I?
Will you,
So is that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're gonna ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one is that you never leave me. God, did you just break your biker ring off my finger?
You know what? I think I probably did.
Look at it. It's so cute with its little fangs just like crunching onto the chain. You know, nothing says true love like
dog skulls.
Dog skulls. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're gonna get me like a real ring, though, right? Not that this one's not
absolutely
great.
Because I just thought that's my ring.
Right, it's your ring. Right. Something more simple, without fangs. I'm sorry.
No, it's your ring.
It's the lab. I gotta get it.
Okay.
Hello? Yeah. No, it's fine. I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. They need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, this time of night?
I'm sorry. I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick.
Let's really? Go. Why didn't you say it, man? I mean, I guess you don't trust him, but... And man, I'm gonna leave it there for this.